cars that go way later than they should. Can I see those cars in the air?
Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me. For me.
Bring it on one night, Willie.
Ooh! Yeah! Your bullets, they're really fast.
Alright guys, so I'm actually sorry I'm very late with this review. I actually did not see this movie opening a weekend because I went to San Francisco. I went to go visit my family. And I had to do something over there real quick. So I did go to the movies, but I went to go see my fourth viewing of Avengers Infinity War. I already put the ticket away, but the receipt's right here. And the reason why I didn't see Deadpool is because I went with my younger cousin, and she's 14, and they're not gonna let us in to go see Deadpool 2. So I just waited for the Tuesday where both my parents were off, and even better, we went to go see it in Dolby. We actually used free movie passes on this movie, and then about halfway through the movie the sound goes off, and then after the movie they gave us another free passes, so I basically saw the movie absolutely for free. And then I went to go see it a second time with my friends this time because it was the last day of school and we had nothing else to do. So I watched Deadpool 2 twice. I think you guys know what I thought about the movie. So yeah, let's get on to the review. So in Deadpool 2, Deadpool ends up meeting Cable, who is this guy who comes from the future. He comes back in time to get this kid named Russell with fire powers, who in the future actually ends up killing Cable's family. So it's basically the whole Terminator storyline where the guy comes back in time to kill the kid. And of course, Deadpool is not going to allow this, and Deadpool is actually going to try to protect this kid from Cable. Okay, it's not only that is the story of the movie. There's probably about another plot line or two in this movie, but I just can't say what it is because it would end up I would end up spoiling the movie for you guys. And of course, some of you guys still haven't seen this movie, and I want you guys to go see this movie because I thought it was really good. Deadpool, the first Deadpool was a really big surprise. Hell, I give it an A+ when I first saw it, but let's remember I was in 8th grade when I first saw it, and back when I was in 8th grade, Deadpool was probably the coolest shit I've ever seen. Because it was an R-rated comic book movie. They had those around, obviously, but nothing like Deadpool. I do have the Blu-ray, the Christmas edition, which I really do like the slipcover. And now rewatching the movie, the movie isn't as good as it was the first time. It's definitely not an A+ worthy movie. It's more of like around a B+, but I still do really like the movie, and I do think that there are some clever moments to that movie, just that right now rewatching it, the humor definitely doesn't hold up, you know, the pop culture references, and this movie has a lot of those, but at least they're not as annoying as they are in the first movie. And now the sequel to Deadpool is here, and I saw it, and I loved it, and I think it's better than the first movie. I know a lot of people that did not like the first one. I mean, at first they kind of liked it, but then they rewatch it and they just don't like the movie no more. And then they watched this movie, they went in with such low expectations that they actually ended up liking this movie. So even if you're not a fan of the first movie, I think you should definitely give this one a try because it definitely kind of is more different than the first movie. Similar to how he was in the first movie, Deadpool is a fun character, and he's actually not as annoying as he was in the first movie. Even when it's just Wade Wilson himself, I still found that part of the character still interesting and actually still kind of funny. And, of course, all that thanks to Ryan Reynolds. He just has a lot of charisma playing Deadpool, and he just has so much fun with this character. He embraces it all on screen, and that's what I just love about this movie Deadpool, movie character Deadpool, because it just portrays him perfectly. Josh Brolin is killing it this year. First he plays the biggest villain in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, Thanos, and the recent Infinity War movie. And now he is playing Cable in Deadpool 2, two Marvel characters, within 3 weeks. That's fantastic, and I loved him a lot in this movie, and I definitely had a lot of fun with Cable, and you know, I just didn't expect this from Josh Brolin because he was really good in this movie. Like, there's just something to Cable's character that is just very likable, and not only that, but he's a very well-developed character as well. I didn't know how I felt about Domino being in this movie, but once I actually saw the movie, I loved Zazie Beetz as Domino. She was a very fun addition to this movie. Domino was represented as such a smart and such a badass female character, and I actually loved her even more than I thought I would have ever loved her in this movie. Now, I don't know the name of this kid who plays Fire Fist, but I know he's been in another movie, I just haven't seen it. It was a Taika Waititi movie, I think it's called Hunt for the Wilder People, I think that's what it's called. But I haven't seen him, but I did see him in this movie, and he was actually really good, and he was actually... I mean, there's something that could have been better about his character, but for what he was as a kid who just curses and all that and just like has these fire powers, he was still pretty good in this movie. And not only that, but we have Dopender back in this movie, who I thought was, maybe he felt a little forced in this movie, but I liked him more than I liked him in the first movie. And I just thought that his scenes were actually funny in this movie. I really liked Dopender a lot in this movie. In the first movie, the humor worked the first few times around, and then after rewatching it, it's not all that funny no more. But at least the humor in this movie, it feels less forced, and it feels like it would hold up on rewatches. Of course, I was still laughing the second time I watched this movie, especially this one certain scene that includes the X-Force once they jump out of the plane. If you've seen the movie, you know what I'm talking about. It's the funniest scene in this movie. It's my favorite scene in this movie, and I know I'm gonna laugh every time I watch that scene. Now, when it comes to the tone in the first movie, I just wasn't a fan how it tried to be a comedy and then it tried to get serious again. It just didn't work out all that well in the first movie, and it wasn't really balanced all that well, but in this movie, it's balanced very well, where the comedy balances well with the more serious scenes in this movie, and the tone definitely worked out more in this movie. I also thought the cinematography in this movie was a bit more professional than it was in the first movie, because the first one just kind of had a little bit of a cheap look to it, but it was made on a pretty cheap budget, so I can't really complain all that much. But here, the budget was probably like doubled, so it looks much better. But some of the CGI on a certain character that I can't discuss about in this review because it would be a spoiler. That certain character, the CGI on that character just kind of felt unfinished. But my problems with the movie itself is, even though I love the humor in this movie, there are certain scenes that I guess are supposed to be serious or emotional, but they have to force in a joke into that scene, just kind of killing that scene. And there are plenty of scenes like that in this movie. And also, there's never really a primary villain in this movie. I'd say this movie kind of juggles between three different villains, and you just don't know which one is the actual main villain. And yeah, I mean, and the other problem I actually kind of had with this movie, I'm sorry, I just forgot to list it. It's the first act of the movie, where sometimes felt like it was giving us way too much, and I just didn't have time to breathe and just like, you know, process the whole first act of the movie. But luckily after the first act, everything is a little bit more balanced and everything gets much better. So overall, Deadpool 2, it was a fun ride from beginning to end. Definitely stay for the end credits. Some of the best end credits I've ever seen. I'm going to give Deadpool 2 an A-. Yes, it improves from the first one, and that's what I really like about this movie. Also, I did see this movie with Dolby Atmos, and I thought it was a pretty fun experience. Although right now, Solo is out, so I don't think there's any Dolby Atmos theaters near that is going to be showing Deadpool, but you'll be fine watching this movie in standard either way. So either way, it's a fun movie. I'd say it's a full prize worthy movie, of course, an A-. That's really good. Yeah, Deadpool 2, really good movie. I hope you guys watch this movie because it's actually a lot of fun. If you guys watched it, tell me what you guys think about it in the comment section down below. As always, thanks so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.